So I got my waders on. We're going to go in there and give it a look. The first criteria we're going to go over are your teal numbers. Now, this is probably your most important criteria just because you could have great cover, great water, everything, but if you don't have the teal, you're going to be wasting your time. All right, so we figured out there's pretty good teal numbers going on here. Probably seen 200 of them. Next most important thing you're going to look for is cover. If you don't have cover, it's going to make it really hard for the birds to come into your decoys or give you any good looks. As you can tell, there's a lot of trees and tall grass, or semi-tall grass, in this fence row here. Fence rows are really good for covering blinds, and you can sit right along a post. With all the water we've been getting here in Nebraska, the water's really pushed up into the pastures of these marshes, and it's going to be kind of hard to find good cover. So if you find a tree like this one here, that's really good. You got teal sitting right in there. Well, I made it out kind of by the cattails. It's pretty deep here. It's up to my waist almost, and I mean, I'm not to the cattails yet, but I imagine it gets pretty deep. But so the third thing I want to talk about is how accessible your hunting spot is. Like, do you have to drag your sled a mile into the marsh, or is it wet all the way in, dry? A lot of marshes around here where you get, they run cows on them, and the cows, they really muck up the entrance, and it can be a pain in the ass to walk through. But here, this pretty good accessibility here. My car's only a quarter of a mile probably, and half the way to where I'm at right now is dry ground. Well, I'd say the first spot was a pretty good success. I mean, a place I've never been to before definitely looked pretty good. Yeah, I'll probably have to come back in a couple weeks to visit it again. The old girl got a little muddy, gosh darn. Hopefully I can freaking get out of here. Well, I got no traction on my tires, but we're sliding out of here. Well, we made it back to the second spot. This place I've actually scouted a couple times before, and it's got a lot of water this year because of all the rain we've been getting here in Nebraska. And you can tell that it's almost over the road in some spots. I guess a good but bad thing about this place is you got lots of cattails. And those cattails, you're going to be able to hide yourself really good, but you're going to be standing in the water the whole time. And I know some people don't really like that. So remember the three criteria to scouting for teal. Teal numbers, your hide, and how accessible it is. That's going to wrap up this video. Thanks for tuning in, and make sure to follow us on Instagram at Cornhusker Outdoors.